get us all up in there.
Let's get a tissue.
Yeah, nasty ass seats.
I put napkins on them, trying to cover it. Oh, they blew it away. It's a bag right there. Sit on the bag. You don't hurt your back. Okay, now mother, maybe if you could lean in a little and everyone lean in, we can get us all in like that.
What you need?
The mics were going in and out because one minute I would hear my mom and I wouldn't hear nobody, and then I would hear Sade and I wouldn't hear nobody else. And then it would be blending in and then it would be out. Like it was in and out.
We're online.
When you was gonna tell us we was live?
It's all good.
So, wait, I didn't even start this. I was trying to make sure that we was all in the thing.
Good afternoon, good afternoon. Welcome to Candid Conversations 2021. And today's topic is misconceptions of church girls. How y'all doing today, though?
Hello.
Hey.
Let me get a little comfortable right here, because we're going to talk today. We're going to talk about a topic that I hadn't heard in too many other places, but let me ask you, when you think about dating and you think about being a Christian female, I know you have experienced a few things if you're dating like poached. And one of those things that we're going to talk about today, the misconceptions about church girls. We're talking about women who go to church and are practicing Christian values. Okay? So when it comes to that, I know a lot of people have different opinions. And we're going to talk about those opinions today so we can also get an understanding and chat about something they really don't bring up in church a lot. Okay? So the misconceptions. Who can tell me what are... Name one of the misconceptions or... the ideas that people have about church girls that just might not be so. Just tell me what you think that is. How about you, Jenny?
I think the biggest misconception that I used to once be misled by is that church girls are perfect. You know, whenever you get an attitude or you get mad and you want to say a few things or... you know, you want to handle a situation a certain way, or I ain't gonna say handle it a certain way. Maybe if you know you just wasn't having a good day and you got caught out of character or something like that, and you acted a little bit, I don't want to use the wrong word, but when you're not being passive or submissive or letting people run you over, you know what I'm saying? They want to. I feel like I'm going into another conversation with that because I was going to talk about manipulation. But people assume that church girls are perfect and they don't get mad and they let people get away with everything and they never want to, you know, get even or none of those natural things that people go through as they process bad things or whatever. You know what I'm saying? Misconceptions that we perfect.
That's a good one. That's a good one because they think, especially when you get that.
Right, when they got you messed up. No, stop.
That ain't the church girl way to be rolling your neck saying stuff. But yeah, that's a good one. What about you, Dominique? What do you think another misconception about church girls?
I think a big misconception is...
Speaking up, though.
Is that you just can't be yourself, like lively, and you gotta be reserved, and you know you have to look a certain way.
Oh, that look and being reserved.
We know about that one.
Yes.
And sitting
some of the misconceptions that I normally hear when it comes to a lot of the church and people is that y'all think that we can't have fun and come to a normal environment because y'all feel like that we're going to be tainted by you and stuff like that. But y'all forget, at one point, we used to be walking them same streets. But if I can come and be in your natural environment, how come you can't come be in my elevated environment? So, you know, that's what I get tired of. Everybody think that we can't have fun, that we don't have barbecues, that we don't have family events, that we don't get together and have fun.
Oh, yeah, we had another place.
But I'm going to be honest with y'all. We probably have more fun than y'all. Real talk.
For real talk.
Yes. And that is so important. Fun is not a word that a lot of people associate with church. So that is a thing that we have to let you guys know that just because you might be considered a church girl does not mean you can't have fun. The Lord freed you to fund them. So
I like it.
So you have to check what you think you know about people. But let me just put this out here. That we got a few things out here so you guys know what we mean by misconceptions or the wrong idea when you hear the term church girls or females who follow Christianity or try to practice Christianity. Okay? One thing I want to say is if you dating out here in 2021 and you are practicing, you know, when it comes to dating, there are people who don't believe in dating without the extra stuff that comes with physical relationships. Okay? One of the things that stand in the way for me is the sex. You know, a lot of people are getting physically involved. And a lot of times when you're dating and you tell a guy that you're not having sex until marriage, you usually end up being by yourself after a couple of dates. But a lot of times when you tell him this is you practice it and that's what you do, at least for me, I'm speaking for me now. When you tell them, then it's like, you know, you're about to be in a room by yourself anyway. And you lose friends. And next thing you know, you in there, you're hearing the crickets, and it's just you. So that is one of the things that I've experienced. Is, it ain't a whole lot of people checking for church girls like that. But, hey, I'm still having fun. Anyway, what do you think is one of the biggest problems that we're having in these days when it comes to church girls and church people? It's one thing when you're a church girl and you're relating to the world, people have these expectations of who you are. But what about when it comes to relating to people that you go to church with? What is one of the biggest problems that you have today? And we're going to take that and start with Dominique. What up?
Wait a minute. I was still processing.
People that practice and believe like you do. What is one of the biggest problems that you may experience today being a church girl yourself with people in-house and their misconceptions?
Some people don't understand my worship. Some people will be like, she's way too into it. She always crying. She always, you know, going overboard with it in their mind. In their mind, it's overboard. But for me personally, when I get in there, that's my time. I don't care who's around. If you don't like it, then hey, move on out the way. I'm going to make sure I don't bump into you or hit you or nothing like that because it ain't intentional. But when I say I'm not worried about what everybody else got to say, some people's too worried about what the other person looking at or saying. That's why you can't freely worship. So then you're stuck. You're stagnant. You're moody. Some of y'all that stay so still, y'all wonder why y'all so miserable. Why y'all not walking around with a smile and stuff like that. But when you freely worship, you feel it. You feel good every day. So I'm going to honestly say that's one of the biggest problems for me is Y'all don't like how or understand how we worship. But hey, on the floor is how I worship. Loud is how I worship.
Well, girls, get down on the floor, on the floor.
Wait. I'm sorry. See, you see, I get it on the frame.
No, Mom, I'm sorry. It ain't been too long. Dominique, are you ready?
Yes. I'm ready. I think for me, the biggest thing would have to be judgment. I think that people forget where they came from. We all have our own individual walks, and I think people need to understand and accept where you are when you walk in the door. You know, don't try to push me to be who you are, because I'm who I am and I'm where I am. You know, it takes people time to get where they're going. So I think that's a big thing. You know, people, they want you to automatically, boom, you're in church, so everything you
change.
You got to change. You walked into church, so now it's different. Yeah. So that's the big thing for me.
That's the judgment, you know. Yeah. Understanding. Jamies, what's your thought?
I think mine kind of piggybacks off of both of theirs. Like for me, I am the crybaby of my church, because I cry when I praise, when I worship, when I just regularly pray, I cry. You know what I'm saying? So for me, I used to be embarrassed about that. You know what I'm saying? Because I didn't understand, like, God, I'm not even sad. Why am I crying? But not even just with that, coming into church, being myself, individuality. Individuality and in the fun aspect. I am a very vibrant person, as y'all could tell. I'm extra. I'm very extra, you know. I like to have fun. I'm silly, and I think I'm hilarious. I think I'm very funny. Everybody doesn't think I'm funny, but coming into church and being a church girl, I think sometimes the older, more seasoned saints, they ain't with all that funny stuff. They not into playing. They don't have personality. Mean to say they don't have personality. Please don't get mad at me.
This candy.
I do not.
You might get mad.
I don't mean they don't have personality. They're just a bit more, can I say sticklers? They're more, can I say that? I don't want to say a bad word. They're more reserved. But people like me, I'm more lax and fun and outgoing, and I have a lot of personality, and I'm very extra, and I have fun. And then just like that, I can get serious.
In the house as well as outside of the house is very, very, very important, because nothing can disturb your spirit as bad as a sister, somebody you serve it with in church looking at you all kind of ways, and you got that judgment, and you be like, Lord, can I just worship you? Can they just be me and you? Because, you know, they don't give me no kind of leeway for nothing. But one of the things we have to understand coming in, and that people very, very, very seldom tell you, is that we ain't all driving at the same speed. Some of us coming up through there on cruise control at 35, chilling, you know, and some of us is like 100 on the highway, like, Lord, you know what I mean?
Some of y'all like a 15, though.
Yeah, 15. Some of us doing the legal limit, you know, it just depends, but we're all going towards the same mark, and I don't want to get on a highway and be like honking my horn because I'm expecting you to go at the speed I'm going. This is not that type of highway.
I used to do that.
And like I said, like my grandfather used to say, we need to get on the cord, the same cord, the one accord, knowing and understanding that we're coming from different walks, coming from different angles. My cross might not be your cross. What I'm coming from and coming through might not be what you're coming through. You might can run through 10 issues or something and be there in no time. It might take me some time. I might have to remove the wall brick by brick. You know what I'm saying? So knowing and understanding that, you know, we're all coming and driving at different speeds on this freeway kind of helps. And knowing that there's a relationship that you have inside of the church that needs to be well as your relationship outside. And when people can understand that there are issues, you know, we got real issues that they don't talk about from the pulpit. I mean, that life change, we get everybody.
But yeah.
That's why we talk candidly like we're doing on camera today. So we can get those things out there and talk to some of you who might be out there in the world experience the same thing and not understanding how to communicate that. We know. We understand. We're taking this walk too. So, in saying that, one last question. We ain't going to keep it too long today. But when it comes to church girls, and by saying that, that is women and young ladies who are out here practicing and following the Christian values and going to church and serving the Lord and doing the work in public and reading the word and studying. If you're doing this, yeah, we're talking about you. Involved or not involved, you're considered a church girl. Because 9 times out of 10, when you let somebody know, when you meet somebody in the street, or if they even see you going, that's their, oh, yeah, street church girl, you know. And they got all these expectations, you know what I'm saying? And if you do something different, first thing I say, see, I told you, them church people, you know. Come on, y'all, stop. Stop that. You know, we didn't say we were perfect. You said that. You know what I'm saying? You said that. But if R. Kelly and them can't, you know, get up and do whatever they're going to do and peeing on people, you still playing and bumping their song. So it's like, come on. How he get to have a break and I know, even though he locked up today. You know, it's just, we have to understand that we're all people. Whether we're doing R&B or gospel, we're still people. And we're all God's people. R. Kelly is a soul of God, just like I am. All I'm saying is, all y'all down here with us, give us a break. You know, lift us up. Encourage us. Say, hey, is that sister? Hey, she go to church. That's a good thing. I'm a blessing to my neighborhood. That's how I look at it. Because I do, though. You know, when somebody say, hey, sister, when you go to church today, mention me, I'm like, oh, God, thank you. You know, and let me know. Everybody don't look at it negatively. That's not what we're saying today. We just talk about those people who say, oh, church girl, and they have these whole list of ideas and expectations that they don't even fit us.
So, confirmation. Don't put expectations on us if you don't put the same expectations on yourself. Hold yourself accountable if you're trying to hold every person that's in the church accountable for something, because we repping him. We've been through that hard time and everything, but at the same time, like, y'all try to hold a church person accountable. Ooh, you cussed. Ooh, you did this. Ooh, you do that. But what about you? Hold yourself to the same standards that you hold us to.
Oh, no, this the one right here. I don't need church for God because I am the church. Well, if you are the church, like the pastor said, you the preacher of your church, what's going on in your ministry? Who getting saved?
Who
getting help? Who all this? So just like y'all be having all these expectations for what y'all think church people are supposed to be like, remember, you're a church too. What's your church looking like? What's your pastor looking like? What's your tithing and offering and the seeds you sowing in the people, the lives you saving and all that other stuff?
How many kids y'all stop from joining gangs and
right.
stuff?
Right. Because in real life, we ain't supposed to be looking at nobody. We supposed to have our eyes fixed on nobody but God. That's where we're messing up at, looking at folks, putting our mouth on people, forming our own ideas about what people's lives should be like when it's not our business. Their walk, our walk, two separate walks. Same path, following God, same destination to the kingdom, but you know, it's different stroke. Can I say that without it being
different stroke for different folks? I'm going to say it right now.
Without it being inappropriate, see the fact that I had to think about that first. Let me say stuff, let me be me without y'all coming for me. So I ain't got to be sensitive.
And then that goes to show you those people that say, oh, well, you know, I'm going to come in when I get it all right, when I'm ready to do it, be 100. No? What's that?
Because ain't nobody perfect.
My thing is this, he said, come as you are. Mm-hmm. But the main thing about that is, come. Okay? Right. At least if you're sitting on the bench next to me and you're talking about me, I'll be like, well, we both in here, Lord, help us both.
Right, help us both.
Okay? Then I'll let you say what you want to. And I ain't got to worry about it. But other than that, you outside, you know, if you ain't tried, you know. Now, one thing about it is that we have fun. It didn't say you can't have fun. He didn't say you won't ever fall again. say you will not sin anymore. It would say that you're going to have all glorious days and every day was going to be fine. Nobody made that promise. But he promised that no matter what you go through, no matter what you're up against, no matter who you meet, no matter what situation, that you got somebody with you.
You ain't never alone.
Never alone. And with this, one of those things that you do to help keep those misconceptions from spreading, how do you change minds in your community or with people that you meet about those misconceptions? Dominique, we're going to start with you. We're going to finish up with this. But how would you talk to somebody who comes to you and say, well, I expected you to be this good Christian girl and you don't fight. You know, you ain't supposed to fight and looking all crazy and being mean. How do you handle that?
Well, with that, I say, you know, at the end of the day, I'm still human. I'm still growing just like you, you know. I go to church to better myself, not saying that I'm better than you, but to better myself, to grow for my personal growth. So when I came into this, yeah, I started at the bottom, struggling, you know. I came from the streets, so, you know, it takes time to get that stuff out of you. It's toxic. It takes time to get that out of you. So as I'm growing, don't judge me for where I am and for the struggles that I'm battling still.
That's right. That's good. That's good. I'm ready for where she is, and she admitted that she's battling this, you know, working on it.
Work in progress.
Pressing towards the mark. Pressing. Every day.
Yeah.
Every day. And what about you, Jerm? What do you think? And what would you do to dispel those myths that people have about so-called church girls? How do you get them to change that way of thinking?
I think I just learned this today at church. It was part of the word today. When he was saying that we have to own it. We have to own it. Okay, God, this is what I did. So if somebody was to come to me, you know what I'm saying? I would first tell them to be accountable for their actions. There's no way to fix something if you don't first recognize it. You know what I mean? And then once you recognize it, you have to own it. And then, like he was saying, I'm finna mess it up because I see it. But it goes from judgment to repentance to restoration. Am I saying salvation. Then salvation? I might be saying it wrong. Like I said, y'all, I just learned this today. So it goes from judgment when you call out what's wrong, you know what I'm saying? And then it goes into repentance to where you are turning away from that thing. And then it goes into restoration when you are being restored. And then the salvation. I hope I'm not messing this up because, like I said, I just learned it. But that is the perfect answer how I feel to the question that's asking somebody needed some advice or something to move past these misconceptions, even the misconceptions we hold for ourselves when it comes to being church girls or church people, period. Okay, that's what I... Listen.
That's how that works. That's how these things work, you know. And what about you, Alicia? What can you do to help dispel those myths that people have about church girls? So we ain't out there disappointing people and putting out ideals that are not true.
So one, jumping off of, you know, learning from church today.
See, we be learning.
Before I step to that word, let go, let God. Two, acknowledge that you're worthy. You're worthy of every bit of this walk that you're walking on. No matter what any of your family members say, your homies say, them girlfriends say, them co-workers say, acknowledge that you're worthy of it. I mean, half of y'all want to be on this walk with us too. Y'all just don't want to acknowledge it yet. So I'm going to acknowledge it for you. If you want to get through them battles, them struggles, that barrier that y'all facing, let go, let God, and acknowledge that you're worthy of every bit of His blessing and love and peace.
That is great. And that's so important to say that. And it was such a rich word that we got today.
It was really good. Y'all follow Life Change Ministries LB.
Yes. We can't help
and make make sure you catch today's word. Catch all the words, because we on it and we rolling, and y'all need to get on the boat.
I mean, if y'all can watch all them other videos like TikTok and stuff, y'all can take a few minutes and watch a live of Life Change or something, or even our podcast.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, let me tell you something about it. When it comes to church, we're just people who are more spiritual, and we have a whole kingdom that we operate outside of being here on this earth, which is the kingdom of heaven, the kingdom of God. And one thing you have to know, when you're a child of the Most High, you are the princess, and you should be treated like one, and you should act like one, yes. But you have to understand, even Meghan and Harry, even the world in England, they have issues. They have stuff, but we don't toss them away. We don't look down. They're still royal. They're still royalty no matter what. People are people. They're human. They have shortcomings. But you still are worthy, because your righteousness is not something you create. Your righteousness you have is because of Jesus Christ. And because he is so good and so worthy, so are we. Okay? So yes, we are treasure girls. Proud to be. And yes, you should respect us in that respect. But do understand at the same time, you know, we're human. Striving to be. Striving.
I want to say, to help y'all. We said what we could do to help us, but what I think would help others is if you just remember that what Susie got going on ain't got nothing to do with Tim, and if you ain't Tim, don't worry about it. All we supposed to do is love people, you know, pray for people, cover people, you know what I'm saying? We ain't supposed to worry about their walk. We ain't supposed to be judging them, and when you get to looking at folks and talking about, oh, ain't you a church girl, remember, so are you. If you another female calling, you know, trying to downplay me, talking about, oh, she a church girl, but she do whoop-de-whoop-whoop-whoop, guess what? You a church girl, too. And you, the pastor of your church, and your congregation is those people who be around you, what it's looking like. So why are you worried about what I'm looking like at my church, and who I'm praying for, and how I'm walking in my life? Look at yourself. Because you a church girl, you a church boy, you a church just like the church that I go to that's brick and mortar. Your body is the temple. So word, fix your church. Don't come for mine. Because I'm at Life Change Ministries. LCM, baby for life. One time for the one time.
See? Don't judge us. Gangsters for the Lord. Women for the Lord.
Y'all know you might get laid hands on.
I'm just saying, okay? We ain't just praying, we slaying and laying hands.
Like you said, I'm a child of God, not an adult of God.
And we ain't pushovers, because God didn't call us to be pushovers. He called us to be great. So therefore, we standing in it, we walking in it, we at this park, there's people around us, and we got it quiet.
Right.
Get us quiet.
And one thing about it, I remember a whole lot, it says in the word that love covers a multitude
of sins.
Okay, love does. It didn't say Miss William does. It didn't say. It said love does. So with love and kind, love.
I
so
love.
When somebody comes and you see your sister down, don't make it lose 3-5. Okay, go in, encourage, lift them up, sister. Can I? I understand. You want to talk? You know what I'm saying? If you ain't got nothing but the scripture, Jesus, what? Weeping Jesus up too. You know, my thing is, let's turn it around. Make these negatives a positive. Let's do positives for one another. In the church, outside the church. How can I help? How can I love? We know what Jesus would do. What Lisa been doing and then change. When I think of what Lisa would do, oh, I gotta change that. You know, because ordinarily, regular Lisa would have been like, girl, did you hear? You know, but this Lisa who's been moshed, dipped, and pressed, and still being pressed,
say,
look, how can I help? What can I do? It's going to be okay. God still loves you. Never throw you. You know, so
y'all have a good night.
She said it comes for the one time, Germanese. Do us out.
Deuces.
How we do. Short and simple.